arts and technology are gifts given to men by the Holy Spirit. When an artist paints a picture, a musician composes a song, an architect designs a building, or an engineer designs a machine, each is using his God-given talent. Every gift should be used to reflect the wisdom of its giver and imitate the beauty and usefulness of his creative work. The humanistic worldview sees culture, art, and technology as existing only for self-expression, human enjoyment, and selfish vanity. The non-Christian uses culture as a way to revolt against God and glorify himself. He thinks he can create out of nothing something totally original. When man creates, he is not creating something absolutely new, but merely discovering a potentiality which has existed from the beginning. Its proper use becomes a blessing from God for the benefit of men, while its misuse becomes a curse for the destruction of men. Because the arts and technology create works that express thought and emotion, they exert a moral influence on one's behavior. The arts and technology can be powerful forms of religious fellowship. Religious because thoughts, emotions, and actions are always moral. And fellowship because of the sharing between artist and audience. For the Christian, this imposes a serious responsibility. It means we are not to enjoy art and technology which promotes thoughts, emotions, and behavior contrary to the Word of God. The Scripture says, "What fellowship has light with darkness?" Instead, students should be taught to enjoy art and develop technology that reflects the glory of God's creation and ministers to others. The student is to develop his talents in harmony with God's truth and law. Furthermore, the Christian should use both the arts and technology, either directly or indirectly, to promote the gospel of Jesus Christ and thereby promote a biblical understanding of God's world. In so doing, the student will learn how to employ his skills to advance the kingdom of God on earth for his honor and glory.